Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today I'm going to show you that how you can create this impossible rectangle rotation effect in PowerPoint 2016 and that you can use as animator loader in your YouTube videos or presentations. Let's get started. And first of all, I'm going to collapse this thumbnail view and going to change the layout to black. First of all, we are going to insert a shape and I am going to choose frame and draw it like here. And if you want to change the width of the frame, then you can do that by adjusting the yellow handler. I think that one is okay. I'm going to remove the shape outline by clicking on the format button and go to the shape outline drop down button and choose no outline. And going to change the fill color to red one, and will also apply shape effect. Like I want to apply bevel, and going to choose angle bevel. That one is fine. And I'm going to write my text, and for that I am going to use the WordArt from the insert menu, and black is okay for me. The teacher, and select the text. Go to the home tab. Choose the font style you want. I want to go with this one. Now adjust both of these text and the frame to the center and the middle of the slide. And for that, first of all, you can go to the view menu and turn on the guides. And that is both of these vertical guides, vertical and horizontal guides are in the middle and the center of the slide. Now select the text and go to the format tab, click the align drop down button and click align center, and then again click on the align drop down button and this time click align middle. Okay, and do that for the frame as well. Okay, the text side be a little bit smaller than the frame. I am going with, let's say, a size of 50. Okay. Make sure to align the objects on your slide in the middle and the center of the slide whenever you change the sizes. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make a duplicate of this frame by going to the home tab, click the copy button and then click paste. Okay, place it below the first one and go to the format tab. And this time I am going to remove the fill color by choosing no fill from the shape fill drop down button, and but want to apply a shape outline, and you can choose any color because later we are also going to remove this outline color later on. So I am going with black one. That's okay. Now again select the frame, the red one, go to the home tab and then click copy, but this time instead of clicking on the paste button, I need to paste this shape as a picture, and for that either I can right click on the blank area of the slide and choose paste as picture, or you can also click the paste drop down button and choose paste as picture from here. Okay, now place this third frame to the side. Okay, go to the format tab and choose the crop command and crop this frame like here. Okay, now and also place this horizontal guide at the end of the frame. Now again select the second frame, make a duplicate of this one by clicking on copy and then click paste. Now place this frame on top of the first one, go to the format tab, click the crop button, and this time I am going to crop it in reverse order. Like I want this area to be visible, so I place this right here and I want to crop it from the top. Now both of these frames are making a single frame. It looks like a single frame, but they are two different frames. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both of these by holding the shift key from the keyboard. Select the first one, hold down the shift key and then click on the second one and then place it on top of the blank frame, just like that. Okay, zoom out a little bit so you can see all the stuff on your slide. Now what you need to do is you need to select all these three frames just like that and go to the format tab and click the group drop down button and make a group of them. Now we no longer require this one, this frame, and select the frame and hit the delete key from the keyboard and make this frame to the center and the middle of the slide. Okay, now we have three frames as a single frame. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a copy of this one again, place it on the bottom and ungroup them. Okay, now delete the top frame and ungroup this one as well and delete the bottom frame and make a group of both of these and do the same for the bottom one. And I want to remove the outline of both of these blank frames, and for that if I select this one it is going to select the entire group instead of the blank frame. So if you again click on the blank frame, then it will select the individual blank frame within from the group. That is a nicer feature in latest version of PowerPoint. And what I'm going to do is I am going to remove the outline and do the same for this bottom group of frames. And for that I select the group and again click on the blank frame and remove the outline. Now place both of these frame as they will look like a single frame, just like this. These red guides indicate the position, the exact position, so it will make easier for you to place the object side by side or to the top and bottom. Now select all of these frame and move them on the top of the text. Remove the guides. Now it's animation time, and for that I select the top frame, go to the animation tab, open the animation pan, adjust the size if you want, and now I am going to apply the spin animation to the top frame, and for that I click on add animation and click spin. Okay, now select the now select the top one and again apply the spin effect to this one as well. Now place both of them just like that, and I want to start both of these animation with previous, and for that I select the first animation, hold down the shift key and then select the second one and click the start drop down button and choose with previous. I want the duration to be 5 seconds. Open the effect options by right clicking on them, and I want to rotate this both of these frames to 360 degrees, but want to auto reverse the effect. They will rotate, make a rotation of 360 degrees, and then will reverse back to counterclockwise. I want a smoothness of, let's say, 4 seconds for the smooth end and 1 second for the smooth start, and I want to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Hit the OK button. And now let me show you the slideshow, and I will explain you that why I use blank frames instead of, I can do this very quickly, but I used blank frames, and why I did so, let me show you that first. If I insert a frame just like that and make a copy and paste it as a picture, and later if I crop it just as we did in previous steps, and if I apply the spin animation to this cropped frame, then you can see that how it is rotating, because the anchor point of this frame is right here. Okay, and we want the anchor point to be here. That is why I choose the blank frames and group them together with the cropped one, so there, as you can see right here, so their anchor point will be in the middle of the object. I hope you got my point. That is why I have used blank frames. Okay, now we have this animation, but that is not perfect right now. As you can see that it is auto reversing back to its previous position. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom out a little bit and want to put this one, this frame, to the back of the all objects. And for that I go to the format tab and send to the back. Now see the animation again. Okay, now we have our main animation, and finally I am going to apply a few animation to the text. And for that I select the text, go through the animation tab, click the add animation drop down button and choose font color. I want to start it with previous, and a duration of 2 seconds is enough for me. By right clicking on the effect and choose effect options, and first of all I would like to change the font color, and for that I go to the format tab. I want it to be white, and now open the effect options, and I want the color style to be this with auto reverse and smooth start, and I want to repeat this animation until end of slide, and would like to change apply the animation by letter with a 5% delay between each letter. Hit the OK button, go to the slideshow. Okay, that's fine. And finally what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a rectangle, a slide size rectangle. Go to the format tab and send it to the back. Remove the outline and choose the color you want. I would like to go with a dark green, and I would also like to apply a fill color animation to the background rectangle, and would like to play it with previous with the duration of 2 seconds, and with the effect options I am going with smooth and auto reverse and repeat until end of slide, and a timing of let's say 5 seconds. Hit the OK button. Let's see the slideshow. That's fine. And finally I would like to apply a grow shrink effect to the text. Grow shrink with previous, go to the effect options, and I would like to grow the text to let's say 110% with smooth ending, auto reverse. And as you can see that animate text is already selected by letter with the 0% delay. Hit the OK button, and I would also like to repeat this animation until end of slide. Now let's see the slideshow, and here we have the impossible rectangle rotation with a few text animations. I hope you will find this video interesting and informative. Let me know by leaving a comment, liking and sharing this video. Thanks for watching and take care.